Herkese merhabalar, videoma hoş geldiniz. This is Twissen. In this video, I'm going to show you the best and the fastest way to record CSGO demos. Besides that, I'm going to show you my editing workflow, my render settings, and also I'm going to give you some useful tips. Before we start, I would like to let you know that by the time you watch this video, some programs, methods, shortcuts, and configs may have changed or completely be outdated. Because of that, I'm going to put an extra info into the description. You can go and check if there are any changes. So, let's get started. Is going to be a little advanced tutorial, so I'm going to fast forward some basic things like installing HLAE, Codecs, etc. Go to the GitHub link given in the description and download my MOVIEMAKING config. Extract it to desktop and go to the link inside HLAE download link text file. Download and extract HLAE to the place where you would like to extract. Then, go to the FFmpeg link inside a text file called FFmpeg download link and download it. It doesn't matter the version you download is stable or beta. I mostly use beta version, but if you have any kind of problem with it, try to use stable version. After that, extract the files inside the zip you downloaded to HLAE FFmpeg folder. That's all for this step, but I recommend you to download and update FFmpeg from time to time by using the same way. This step is not necessary, but if you do not want to encounter any kind of problem, especially about playing back footages, importing them to editing software, etc., make sure you do not skip this step. Install the latest version of Keylight Mega Codec Pack. Do not forget to check all of the codecs from the list while installing it. After that, download and install QuickTime and Avid codecs. You can find the links in the description. Step, if you have your own MOVIEMAKING config, you can just extract ffmpeg.cfg inside my MOVIEMAKING config to your config folder. After that, you can add alias or bind to your config if you want to execute it faster. Here are some examples. However, if you would like to use my MOVIEMAKING config, make sure you have your entire gaming config backup. Then, delete all the files inside your config folder, drag and drop the configs inside my MOVIEMAKING config folder, and that's pretty much it. You do not need to do extra binding process as we did on the last one. When you type FFmpeg on console, it is going to automatically load FFmpeg config. So, you're basically good to go. Launch HLAE, but do not run it as administrator. I used to use the custom loader in HLAE to launch CSGO, so you can follow me to see how I do, or you can use your way. If you are using my MOVIEMAKING config for the first time, don't forget to add this to launch options in HLAE. You can simply copy and paste everything inside HLAE launch options text file. After the launch, execute your config and load a demo. In this step, make your adjustment and add merge streams that you want to record. In this case, I'm going to add a raw and a depth stream. Then, execute the FFmpeg config. When you execute the FFmpeg config, it is automatically going to create a Prores preset for the streams. You can check presets from the console and change it if you would like. But I highly recommend you to go with the default TX0 preset. It is the best one I got so far, and I'm using it on my every project. Names and numbers can change, but I mostly say the preset I use for FFmpeg as a default. So do not panic if you somehow can't see TX0, just use a default. After that, we are pretty much done. Set your frame rate and start most streams recording. If you are using my MOVIEMAKING config, just press F4 to start and F5 to stop the recording. FFmpeg recording location is the same location you set for standard TGA recording on your config. For my config, it's inside a game folder called CSGO Recordings. Before we jump into editing programs, let me give you some technical information about our footage. The footage we recorded is encoded in 10-bit YUV444 Prores. Prores has intra-frame encoding, which means every frame encoded individually, which also means previous inside video editing software are going to be a lot faster compared to the non-intra containers. The chroma subsampling is 444, so you'll have extra pixel quality and flexibility while color grading. The container is Prores KS, aka Prores Kostya, and it has been set to very high quality. Bitrate values are really depends on motion, but they are high enough to get decent quality with low file sizes, especially compared to uncompressed recordings. Some of you may already know, but I would like to introduce you to a third-party render engine called After Codecs. It's a really good hardware accelerated render engine available for After Effects, Premiere Pro, and Media Encoder that gives you extra rendering options on those programs. You can go to their website, download the trial version, buy a full license, or you can use your way to have it. Don't forget to install After Codecs before you jump into editing programs. By the way, After Codecs version 1.8.0 has crashing problems, so I do not recommend you to use it. I usually edit my CSGO clips on Vegas Pro and switch to After Effects for effects and color grading. I'm not going to show you the process on Premiere Pro because it's pretty similar to After Effects. So let's start with Vegas Pro. To be able to open the recordings on Vegas, make sure you use Vegas Pro 17 or a newer version if there is any. The same thing goes for Premiere Pro, but some older versions like CC 2018 and 17 may work. Import the clips to Vegas. Open up project settings. Set your frame rate and change fill order to none, progress if you can. Then you can follow me for the rest. These are my project settings for CSGO editing. If you think that I did something wrong, please let me know in the comments. While you're editing, you can see how responsive the footages are. I'm not going to do any editing on them because I do not want to make this video longer, so I'm directly going to render them. If you are going to render it for After Effects, which is what we are going to do in a second, you can render it as a standard 8-bit uncompressed AVI, but I recommend you to use Prores to maintain nearly everything the same. Go to the Magic's Intermediate section, select a template and click Customize a template. In template settings, modulate your resolution and frame rate to your project settings. Change profile to intermediate 444XQ. Leave the rest on the video tab as it is. Go to the project tab and set video rendering quality to best. Save the template and start rendering. If your final render is going to be on Vegas Pro, you can use the same way and do the final encoding process on Media Encoder with After Codecs. or you can use third-party render engines for Vegas Pro like Vocoder. The footage you have rendered may look like it's not working, but when you import it to editing software, it is going to work without any problems, so you do not need to worry about it. Because the footage rendered on Vegas Pro is ProRes, we're going to have the same responsiveness on After Effects too. Import the rendered footage to the After Effects and do whatever you want to do with it. But don't forget to set the color depth to 32-bit. When you're done, add your composition to the render queue. Let's say you uploaded a clip to YouTube. The clip you uploaded is going to be re-encoded and be converted via UV444 to via UV400. Because of that, you will have less overall quality and you won't benefit from via UV444 on YouTube. However, there's a thing that you can do to increase the overall clip quality on YouTube. But what is that? Well, upscaling. If you go to the official YouTube recommended encoding settings article, you can see that clips at higher resolutions and also clips at higher frame rates are going to be re-encoded at much higher bit rates. So even if upscaling you are going to do won't affect the final rendering quality visually, it will affect overall YouTube clip quality. So how to upscale our clips? Create a new composition at a higher resolution. Add your final composition into the high resolution composition you created. Scale up the final composition. Before you render, add a small amount of sharpen, but not too much. And that's it. In conclusion, if your clip is at 4K resolution, you don't need to do such things. But if it's not, and if you want to have the best quality possible on YouTube, you can use this way. Go to output module settings and change it to aftercodecs.mov. You can use aftercodecs mp4 if you would like to. Then change depth settings to trillions of colors. You may also change audio output bit to 32. After that, click aftercodecs format options. Here is where the magic happens. Choose standard H.264 in the video codec section. Change trade-off to bitrate, with that way you can set your bitrate value. You are seeing my bitrate recommendations for different resolution and frame rates. I'll set this one to 90, but you can go even higher if your internet upload speed is high. For the speed slider, I usually set it to 2 or 3 if the project I'm working on is long and heavy, and I set it to 1 if it is not. Don't ever set it to 0, it's unnecessary. In the color section, I must go with 8-bit because it's easier to playback for my clients. But if you want everything maxed out, you can use 10-bit. We are going to choose YUV444, and because of that, the range has to stay at the TV range. Otherwise, we may have washed out colors on our clips. For the MISC setting, in most cases, I use film. But if you have an 8K project or a bad computer, I recommend you to use fast decode or no tuning. For the GOP value, YouTube suggests using half of the project frame rate, but I set it to 1 intro frame to be able to have smooth editing experience on the clips for the future. Set audio codec to AAC and change audio bitrate to 384 kilobits per second or max it out. Lastly, enable the fast start option, click OK and start rendering. When the render is finished, if you want to send a clip to your client and at the same time upload it to your channel, upload the clip to Google Drive first. Then use the Drive extension called YouTube Uploader for Drive, or go to Google Photos, click Upload, choose the clip from your Drive, and wait until it is completely processed. Go to YouTube, click Upload, switch to the old YouTube Uploader, then click Import button in the Import Videos section. By doing that, you uploaded your clip to YouTube and you had the link of the clip for your client. Easy peasy. That was all for this video. If you have any question, write it down in the comments. I hope you liked it and found it useful. Don't forget to like and consider subscribing if you do. Bir sonraki videoda görüşmek üzere. Hoşça kalın.